Evening, folks. I'm Jason, and welcome back to Mecha Taco. This is my fourth attempt at recording this video. Operator malfunction. That's all I can say. I can't blame it on the computer. I can't blame it on the recording software. It was my own ineptitude and incompetence. And I'm proud of that. I'm proud that I'm an idiot sometimes. A lot of times. Most of the time. So tonight we are continuing PN3, product number 3, which I've been informed is the actual way of pronouncing the title is PN3, not PN03 or PN03. What can I say? It's old habits. That's just how I've always pronounced it. So I'm breaking that habit today for you. I hope you're happy. In any case, let's get started. Let's turn down the ink spots here. It chose the song Slap That Bass, and I don't think I need to explain why. I'll just let your imagination figure that one out. And everything's set. Let's load the game up, shall we? Picture. There we go. Yay! Everything's working? Recording? Audio? Good. No, not that one. Not that one. Dang it. Yeah, can I quit? I can't quit. I had tried loading a, let's try that again. Ooh! Total crash. Ah. Yeah, it's one thing after another tonight. I had tried, using some some cheat codes, some action replay codes or something, and they worked. But you know, at the same time, I was like, I don't know, even for me, I don't feel quite right doing that. Maybe we'll do that later, like towards the end or after the end, just to, you know, fool around, but for now, I don't think it's necessary. Now, that being said, in order to, like, max out your suits, that does require quite a bit of grinding, and that was the main reason, that was my logic behind making this change, or trying the cheats. But again, I was like, you know, it's not like I'm struggling, really, you know, so let us run with it for now. Alright, this is your next target. Looks kind of like a train, almost. Looks almost like a train, kind of. One or the other, Vanessa. You'll find out soon enough if it's a train or not. Oh my god, what's with the dialogue? All I have to do is destroy it, right? That's right. Well, thanks for the details there, Ace. How's my volume? My volume okay? It seems like it's okay. Alright, Vanessa, let's get going. Sorry. It's been like a day, so I'm getting my buttons right. Okay, we're good. A bit of slowdown there. That actually would be the emulator. I wonder why it's doing that, actually. On my system, I don't know how Dolphin works on everybody else's, but with mine, I have to, the emulator has to cache the sound effects, which is very strange. And once it does, it's golden. I mean, everything's fine. But it does mean that there's a pause until the sound is made. I'm not sure how that cache clears after time, but it does. Whoa. Good try. Oh, jeez. Come on, shoot it. Shoot it dead. Nice shot there, Vanessa. Whoa, hello, what is that? Right, left is my special, I have to remember that. Now, that doesn't look healthy. Whoa. Right, left. Turn around, Vanessa. Now, I have to say, I've had a few comments on the videos, not on the videos themselves, but rather on Vanessa's posterior. And first thing, I fully admit it makes me smile, just because we're talking about polygonal butt, and that to me is just amusing. Now, how are you holding up? Well, we're the player's talking about my ass. That's how we're holding up. There are two exits, but one of those is locked. Aren't you going to tell me which one? I think you're old enough to figure it out for yourself. Man, you son of a... Swears. I hate this employer. He or she is not paying me nearly enough to throw away this garbage. Now, the general opinion, let's go over here, this looks fun, is that her sit-upon is well, for lack of a better word, flabby. I don't know if I agree with that. Maybe it's just me. And I realize I'm having this conversation or this argument right now, and it's kind of bizarre. It's not really bizarre, but it's silly. And please note that this is being said very lighthearted. You know, I'm not seriously upset by these comments or invested in this argument. It's easy on the internet to allow anything, no matter how mundane or ridiculous, get out of hand and blown up into a much bigger deal than it actually is. And this is the type of conversation I would have, like, with close friends when we're all very exhausted and just fooling around with a game. Not making any sense, that sort of thing. But here I am, you know, having this conversation online to complete strangers who think I'm obsessing over a video game character's ass. That's not flabby. I think it probably looks flabby because the way she's standing. Her hips aren't on a flat horizon. They're at an angle. So it's not like one butt cheek is happens to be flabbier and just kind of hanging there low. I don't see the flab, but I do sincerely appreciate that that was an observation. I think that's what I'm trying to. That's what I'm trying to say, is that I really, really, really appreciate the fact that somebody thought this. That makes me smile. Needed that power up, thank you. I don't agree. I think she has a pert little buttocks. I can't believe I'm saying any of this. But, you know, whatever. It'll come back to haunt me, I'm sure. I like to blame it on something like, oh, I'm hopped up on cold medicine right now. But no, I'm not, really. I am a little tired, but that's no excuse. Am I objectifying the character? Oh, yeah. See, that's what I'm trying to say, is that don't take any of this that seriously if you are. It's, I'm not objectifying anybody. It's, we're talking about a silly video game. Though clearly there was a lot of love put into those hips and those cheeks. Quick. Oh, that's close. Thank you, man. Oh, this camera. There, nope. That's the ass cam, apparently. Don't want that. Or do it. There we go. No damage. Yeah, I'm rocking it. It's like an F-Zero stage. Or one of the less beautiful days on Cloud City. Coincidentally, Lando Calrissian is like my favorite Star Wars character. I don't think I need to explain why. He's just suave. Whoa, looking a little undead there. Yeesh. Sorry. I didn't mean to add that sound effect. That's the sound effects I make when playing cards with my 1-year-old. Oh, something in my eye. This is the wrong time to have, like, my eye itch. Where are you? There you are. Ooh, I did a lot of damage with that. Get behind it. Oof. That was lame. Oh, my eye is itching again. So this boss fight isn't going well. Well, it's going okay, I suppose. Oh, and I just got totally run over. That's cool. Evidently, I was doing my super, which made me invincible. So what's the point of this guy? Like, why is he there? I mean, he's on a track in the middle of a building. That just doesn't seem helpful. Oh, new suit. Expensive suit. Man, see, this is why we need the... That's a good one. This is why we need the infinite money. That's a good one too. That's a really good one. Ultra fusion. Crap. I can't afford it. Look at that. It's 600 grand just to buy it. And then, excuse me, I really need to rub eye boogers out of my eye, apparently. I know, that was a lovely thought. And very eloquently put. But, you know, it's the things we do. So, anyway, yeah, look at that. That's great. It's got a four-level palm shot and automatic. That's a badass outfit. Look at all that stuff it has. Is it even worth it? I could buy... You know, with the money we have... there's no way I'm saving up another 500 grand to buy that suit in this playthrough. Up, down, up, A. Wow, that takes up a lot of energy. Oh, well. Sure. I should save. I should definitely save. What do you think? I mean, should we... I'm looking for somebody to tell me, yeah, you know, let's go ahead and do the infinite credit cheat. No, I'm not going to. Not now. I want to, because I'm... found myself getting tired of this suit. It's a fine suit. This time, I want you to take care of a job that was left unfinished. Unfinished? There was one area you couldn't access since it was locked. I've managed to unlock it. Go in and destroy the core. The enemies in this area are expected to be much tougher than when you last infiltrated the area. Be careful. Copy that. Roger. Oh, well, hang on. It's through Terminator Warp while I enjoy my frozen Coke here. Huh. So, I'm looking at the side of this polar pop here. And it says, see if I can put up the still store. Planters, Oscar Mayer, and Circle K. Planters plus Oscar Mayer plus Circle K. That is a recipe for disaster. Of epic proportions. Individually, they're fine. Together, maybe not together. Jump, jump. Jump. Sorry. Just had to look over at my side there. Whoa, hello. Jerks. Oh, what is that? Oh, it's a shield. Okay, so, how does the shield go away? How does the shield go away? Wait. Up, down. No, up, down, up. That's where it is. That's one way to do it. There's got to be a better way to take down the shield. But that works well enough for now. Nice way to clear out the enemies there. Flabby, I don't see it. I don't see it. Oh man, crap! How do you? Do I have to like get right in there then? I can target it, but there's got to be a button to change targets that I just haven't tried yet. All right, well, one more thing about the butt, and then I promise that is it. Until I bring it up again. I think it is a... There is a... bit of a natural movement to it. Which is something you don't really see in games. Or haven't seen in games in quite some time, actually. How do I target other things? Button config. Command entry. Lock on target. Switch lock on target. That's funny. Okay. I don't know what button that is. Let's jump. It's gotta be. Oh, this sucks. Oh, what is it? That's actually a problem. Oh, crap. Hang on. That would be my jump. That's my fire. It's gotta be one of these. Hang on. What am I missing? There. Duck, jump, fire. That's it. Jeez. It was the button I wasn't actually pushing. I'm like pushing every other button, including the analog pads themselves, trying to figure this out. And it's the most obvious thing. It's right in front of me. That's fine. Whatever. Now, for those of you just joining, for whatever the hell reason, this game, we're playing the game through Dolphin, a GameCube and Wii emulator. It was not originally widescreen. However, this is one of the few games where widescreen works very, very well. The widescreen hacks, that is. The only real artifacts are... Oh, shoot. Really? Nice. Are the stretched 2D imagery. So, like, this screen is actually stretched. The title screen is stretched. And my health meter up there. The combo meter as well. But it actually... Wow. I mean, it's still incredibly impressive. The artifacts really are minimal. Jeez. Oh, that's bad. I don't know how I managed to dodge that. I turned around. Stupid camera. I'm assuming, I think this is the way I'm supposed to go. But as far as, like, you know, drawing outside the screen is concerned, I mean, it handles it very, very, very well. Oof. There are no, right now, that we haven't encountered any, there aren't any, like, real glitches, per se. It's very, very clean. The game upscales great. I mean, the only... Let's see, okay. I've managed to unlock the front hatch. Go through there. Okay. You know, with very few texture exceptions, you know, the game cheats by having such, you know, plain environments, but they're very stylized. And, you know, you can boost the resolution without losing detail, which is very, very nice. You know, one, the only change, you know, I would like to see would of course be a higher frame rate, which you can achieve via Dolphin, but it doesn't quite work, you know, the way... that's bad. The way one would want it to. It speeds up the game. It doesn't just speed up the animation. You know, frame rate changes in emulated games is difficult to pull off well. In fact, honestly, aside from like stabilizing frame rate, which is a totally different issue, making a game run at a frame rate it wasn't meant to run, you know, can obviously lead to problems. I don't actually need... Oh, no, I do. Let's go over and get that. The one game that I've seen it done very well, in fact, is a GameCube game. Super Mario Sunshine. That wasn't gonna happen. There's a series of hacks that basically boil down to like some cheat codes that somebody has figured out that allows you to run the game at 60. Now, it's very strange. It works for me, provided I'm playing the game in a window. It can be a large window, that's fine, but it has to be a window. The moment I go full screen, I lose it entirely. The frame rate, it just dies. It's far below 30, actually, which is, you know, absurd. But in that window and running at 60 frames, I mean, it looks like the game looks like that's what it's was meant to do. And it's crazy. It's crazy to... Well, that door's not working. It's crazy to think that actually works. But yeah, Super Mario Sunshine, I mean, it looks very nice running at, you know, 1080p. Running 1080p at 60 frames per second, it's very pretty. Don't do that. You know, that's one thing I've noticed. It's funny, my son has actually been playing Super Mario Kart Double Dash up on my GameCube. Upstairs, and looking at it on a standard definition TV running through S-Video, it's a very nice looking game. Now, running it emulated, you see, of course, you see a lot more flaws. But running through standard definition, I know it's a ridiculous thing to say, and it sounds like something, you know, like a purist would say, like, oh, you know, scan lines are death, you know. But in this case, I mean, you know, you can't even tell the difference between the video, like the compressed video, and the gameplay. And that is impressive to me. And it's not like the image looks duller. The image is still looks very sharp, very vibrant. It's just, yeah. It's a different experience. So yeah, running this game on a standard definition television, it looks fine. Running it emulated at native resolution on a high-def monitor, not so fine. That's why when you're able to boost the game up, it looks, you know, pretty nice. Very nice, actually. Oof. Did not want that. I'm kind of regretting playing on easy, actually. Oof. I feel like I'm probably selling myself short. I say as I get mauled. Whoa, 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 whoa. Nice. Anybody else? Oh, but my original point was that the GameCube really did produce some very, very pretty games that upscale beautifully. It's very clean stuff. Deadly laser rave here. I should need that. Camera. There. Ooh, that's bad. Up, down. Could have gone better. Jeez. Gotcha now. You know, an argument I see, and I do agree with, to some extent, is that, you know, a lot of 2D games still look good today, whereas 3D games, forgive me for saying this, haven't aged well, which, again, is a stupid statement, but you do know what they mean by that. Hang on, I gotta shoot the core. I have a feeling I need to get down quickly. So far, so good. Core seems to be locked. Ooh. Where? I don't know where that came from. I need that continue. Jump button. Jump. Thank you. Um, There we go.
Kablam.
Amateur. I mean, I earned nothing from that. I can't even buy a power-up for my suit. Oh, I can buy more energy. A stronger barrier, I guess. Sure, why not? That's weak. Basically, you know, the idea is that, you know, the sprites just are ageless. You know, they, no matter what resolution you run them in, they always look the same. And if you happen to like sprites, then, you know, you're good. I'm saving again. Just an old habit of saving twice. Whereas, for example, old Saturn games or PlayStation games, you know, you try playing them today and you're just like, ugh, you know, I can't deal with these these terrible polygons. Delicious. Which is understandable, because a lot of them do look like just terrible. But you know, if you manage to boost that resolution up, provided enough care was put into the design of the game, you know, if the game was not going for realism, essentially, if the game accepted the fact that, you know, we're working on a limited, we have limited capabilities, let's create a world around those limitations. Let's not, you know, go for realism. Let's not try to make a convincing, you know, human being. As long as you stylize your polygons just slightly, when it's when the game is thrown into a higher resolution, it actually can look quite nice. You know, the case in point, this game. You know, the close-ups of Vanessa, particularly her face with whatever skin texture they, you know, photographed off of a corpse. You know, it kind of doesn't quite work. But everything else about the game does. It works fine. Yeah, why not? This is the next target. Are you going to tell me what it is? I can't transport you directly to where the target is, so you'll have to infiltrate from the outside. That's not what I asked. When you are transported, the sun will be on the other side of the planet. It'll be dark, so watch out for the searchlights. If they spot you, the night will turn into a shooting spree, and you will be the target. How disturbing. It's pretty disturbing. I'll transport you now. How disturbing, that's your response. How perplexing. Not a huge fan of the outdoor environments. It doesn't look too bad here, though. Probably because it's, you know, dark. Kind of strange. I mean, there's a lot of land here to explore. I don't know if I should actually be doing so. Yay. Stealth missions. Oh. I'm no good at stealth. Whoa. Well, it wasn't perfect. Alright. Oh, that's gonna be awkward, isn't it? I need to pause it real quick. I'll be right back, folks. Parenthood calls. There we go. We're back. Okay. Sorry about that. I mean, for you, it was like not even a second. For me, it was a bit longer than a second. All right. Let's try that again. Where everything... Oh. Sorry. There we go. The game soundtrack. Yeah, everything's recording. Okay. Bear with me for a second, folks. I need a drink. Ouch. The little one has got a little bit of a, I don't know if it's a cold or if it's allergy, but past few nights he's been stuffy, and eventually, you know, his nose will clog up and he won't breathe out of his nose, and it obviously upsets him. So you kind of have to do the whole dying PlayStation maneuver on him. You have to keep rotating him until the game boots, until you find a comfort spot for him. It looks like I finally got him down. I mean, he's out. He doesn't wake up. He's just, but he'll, you know, he whimpers and cries. And yeah, it's awful. It's not fun. So I don't know if I've I'm sure I've stated it before. I'm not a fan of stealth missions. I feel like very few games can pull it off. Unless, you know, that's the whole point of the game, is stealth. That's cute. That's gonna hurt. There we go. That was ugly. That was super ugly. You know, what was it? Metroid Zero Mission. I was not a huge fan of the bonus mission at the end. It was just this very, very long stealth segment. Very long. I mean, seriously, that would not end. Zero Suit or not, it was dull. Ouch. I'm thinking about the end of my rope for tonight. Once we beat this mission, I'm calling it. What was it? What other game? A lot of games, you know, force stealth into their games. That's the one that really sticks out. Shantae and the Pirate's Curse did it. I think it was Pirate's Curse, but I don't know. That one didn't bug me so much. And that could be because it wasn't terribly difficult once you figured out, you know, the mechanics behind it. Wow. Hello. dodge. Oh, hey, I didn't know there was a hole there. I should probably stay in that hole. Ooh! She looks so dejected. I died. Well, I've been racking up the continues, though, haven't I? That's good. Up, down, up? Yeah, up, down, up. Wow, that was rough. It wasn't good at all. I didn't know I could get run over by the tank. I should have known. Death. Okay. I should be safe here if I do this, right? Yeah. Can that thing hurt me from all the way over there? Oh shoot, that's awful. Whoa! I'm just gonna throw myself in the pit and die. Very emotional robot. I have no money. I am totally... Yeah, I don't know. I think we're gonna use the code, because this is... I'm never gonna be able to upgrade a suit this way, unless I do the trial modes, and then I'll be here for another 20 million episodes. Let's save it. Let's save it for tonight, regardless. Yes. And tomorrow, we'll boot up the code, give us infinite credits, buy a bunch of cool suits, and go from there. That's good. That's good for tonight. Yeah, no, I'm fine. Are you good? I'm good. We're all good. Everybody's good. And with that, I shut that down. Do you want to stop current emulation? Yes, please. Yeah, whatever. Okay. There we go. Oh, I just have to paste the two files together in quick editing. No big deal. So, that's it. That's all I really have for you tonight. There we go. I still really do like this game, and it is definitely one that you could just kind of chill out and farm to. You know, the nature of the Mecha Taco format doesn't really allow for that, and I am trying to break that habit. It really is a habit. A drive for me to, like, you know, hurry up and beat these games so I can move on to the next game. I don't know if I should be changing that up and just, you know... I feel like if I just fool around with a game here and there... What the hell? There we go. If I fool around with a game here and there, I'm never going to complete a game. And I'll be right back to the situation of having this enormous backlog. And also just not showing you anything. Because I have the attention span of a 5-year-old. So, what I'm doing now, even though I end up using save states, even though I get frustrated towards the end, it does allow me to complete these games. You know, gaming as a hobby isn't quite as relaxing as one might expect. It's not like... When you sit down to play a game, it's different than sitting down to read a book or to watch a movie. Most movies, for example, aren't a huge time investment that stress you out. You know, did I say stress or did I say stress? That stress you out. Oh, ask for your rabbit. Oh God, I'm tired. Stress you out. am I on camera? No, I'm not. There we go. I'm kind of on camera. Books and movies don't typically do this to you. Games do. Games make you nuts. Good hobby, though. In any case, I have got things to do. You've got things to do. Let's just part ways amicably, and we'll see each other tomorrow and go from there. Good night, folks. Give it a bit of